Hello, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Hannah and I'm a part-time reseller on the Poshmark app. In today's video, we're going to be going over the results of an insane sharing experiment where I shared my closet every 15 minutes for 12 hours straight. Now, before we get too far into it, I have to admit that this is actually a repeat experiment. I did this experiment back in December. There's a whole video on my channel about those results if you care to go back and watch that, but I'll just give like a quick little summary right here. Basically, back in like November, December of 2020 was so painful for me as far as Poshmark goes. I was making no sales. My Poshmark closet in general, like the notifications and the activity, it was just dead. Like there was nothing happening. I was getting nowhere near my like normal or average amount of likes on an item or offers on items or like anything like that. People were not taking me up on offers to likers. And there are just so many things that could contribute to that in my Poshmark closet at that time. And after I posted that video, I got a lot of comments saying, yes, it's happening to me too. I have no idea what's going on. It's been so slow. I'm not making any sales. But the point of me saying that here is just that the purpose of that experiment at that time was to see if I could literally make any sales because it was not happening naturally in the way that it usually had been. Ultimately, the results of that experiment were shocking to me, and I told myself in that video that I would redo this experiment at a later date when things were sort of like back to normal, back to how they usually are, when I was making my normal amount of sales and my Poshmark activity was sort of back to a normal level after the holidays. So here we are, it's February, things are seeming a little bit more normal, and so I gave it another shot, and those are the results that I want to talk about today. First things first, I said this in the other video, but it needs to be restated here that this is not a realistic sharing strategy. This is so tedious, so time consuming and exhausting, and I would never, ever, ever in a million years recommend that you do this on a daily basis. This experiment is extreme, and the purpose for this video is more informational and for entertainment purposes, not because I'm suggesting that this is what you need to be doing to make sales. All right, so let's get into it. As I structure most of my Poshmark experiment videos, I kind of lay out the parameters, how I set this experiment up, then we'll go over the results, and then I'll kind of like break down my thoughts about it all at the end. For this experiment this time around, I actually did kind of change up the structure a little bit because last time I was comparing 2 days side by side. On the very first day is when I shared my closet every 15 minutes, and then on the second day I shared my closet once an hour, which is what I normally do. So the point of that was to kind of compare like what does this extreme sharing do in comparison to what I normally do. I think that's really valuable information, so I'm keeping that, but I swapped the days. So on the very first day I tracked my normal activity as a result of my normal sharing strategy, which is just once an hour, and then I compared it to the second day, which is when I shared every 15 minutes. So I just kind of swapped the order of those sharing strategies because I felt like if I did all the sharing on day one, then some of that activity might like trickle over into day two when I was like trying to track my normal results. I'm trying to improve the accuracy this time around. So by sharing normally on the first day and then going into the crazy sharing the second day, I'm hoping that I'll get a better gauge for like what would actually happen on a typical day versus this crazy sharing day. So knowing that, the very first day that I did this experiment was Saturday, February 20th, and this is when I shared once an hour on the hour from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. in Mountain Time. I shared for the first time at 9 a.m. and the last time at 9 p.m., so that meant that I was sharing my closet 13 times that day. At the time of this experiment, I had 109 active listings, which took me right under 2 minutes to share. What this means is that throughout the day, I spent 26 minutes actively sharing. And I want to pause and address something right here because in the past, in other videos, when I've talked about like, oh, it took me 2 minutes to share, 3 minutes to share, people are like, how? How are you sharing that fast? It can't possibly be true because I can't share that fast. I have talked about this tip in other videos, but maybe not the sharing videos themselves. And the reason that I can share that fast is because I don't do it through the app. I have an iPhone, so what I do is I go to Safari and I go to poshmark.com and I log in through Safari, and you can click the buttons so, so much faster. There's no lag time in between each click. I haven't shared using the Poshmark app in like probably a year by this point. It's so slow and it just frustrates me. So once I discovered how fast it was through Safari, I did that and I never looked back. Okay, so knowing that, moving on, let's talk about Saturday's results. Let's see what kind of activity my Poshmark closet had from sharing once an hour. On Saturday, I had a total of 18 likes, pretty consistent throughout the whole day. Nothing like super shocking in this data hour to hour. As far as shares go, I had 47 shares throughout the day and I had 42 new followers. If you're looking at all of this data in front of you, there's not really any massive like spike throughout the day in any of these areas. They're all pretty low numbers and they're all pretty consistent hour to hour. Moving into Sunday, this is the day that I shared my closet every 15 minutes from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m. again. So I tracked data from the same time ranges on both Saturday and Sunday. This means that I shared my closet 47 times throughout the day, which equates to 94 minutes of actively sharing. And let's take a look at what this did to my closet. On Sunday, I had a total of 30 likes. I had a total of 235 shares, and I had a total of 39 new followers. Looking at all of this together, the likes and the followers, pretty stable hour by hour, but with the shares, we do see a lot larger numbers here. Specifically, I wanted to point out between 5 and 7 p.m., there are some pretty large numbers there, but it's important to note that for each of those hours, it was just one person going through and sharing a ton of my listings. But for the other hours throughout the day, those were truly just like individual people sharing individual items. If we look at these sets of data side by side, we can kind of see that on the day that I shared every 15 minutes, I had roughly double the number of likes. I had 5 times the number of community shares and about the same number of followers on both days. This makes a lot of sense to me. I feel like I should see a lot more likes on a day that I'm sharing that much. I feel like I should see a lot more shares as well. The followers, this has happened time and time again. With all of my experiment videos where I'm like comparing these sets of data, the followers are always consistent no matter what I'm doing. And this is more validation for me that followers don't mean anything. You just gain them by being on Poshmark. Unless you are actively following people to try and get them to follow you back, you're going to have roughly the same number of followers every single day just by having a Poshmark account. Let's get to the exciting stuff because obviously shares, likes, follows, that's cool. I want to know about the offers and sales though. On Saturday, when I shared my closet once an hour, I received one offer that resulted in one sale. On Sunday, I received 3 offers. All of those resulted in a sale, and I made an additional 3 sales from using my closet clear out strategy. What I really want to draw attention to is that on these 2 days, I received 4 offers, which is completely abnormal for me. I rarely receive offers out of the blue. If I had to give my best estimate, I would say like maybe 1 a week. And that's not even accounting for if it's reasonable or not. Like they're usually not reasonable enough to accept. So the fact that I got 4 over the course of those 2 days is really impressive to me. And I attribute this to the fact that I was just continually sharing my listings and all day long they were at the top of search results. So people who were searching for those things came across them and then submitted an offer to me. Another important thing to know is that all 7 of these sales from this weekend came from people who liked things that day. So these were not sales that came from pre-existing likers who finally decided to purchase it. It was like they saw it, they liked it, they bought it in that one day. So that's kind of another signal to me that those came directly from this sharing that I was doing because those people may have not found my items if I was not sharing them that often. So those are all the numbers and data that I collected from this experiment, but if you care to know, I'd be happy to share the things that sold because some of them were pretty surprising to me. On Saturday, the thing that sold was this Eileen Fisher sweater. I was surprised that this sold because it was getting no activity. It was not a popular listing. It was listed for 34 days before it sold, which is like a pretty decent amount of time. Like I feel like that's reasonable, but I remember the notification popping up on my phone and I was like, someone wants that sweater. Like no one has wanted that sweater this whole time. So I was very happy with that. The first thing to sell on Sunday were these Crocs wedges. They sold through my closet clear out strategy and I am so, so happy that somebody finally took me up on this because these shoes were brand new. I feel like they're pretty cute and they got a lot of interest and activity, but I feel like because I listed them going into fall, they just kind of sat throughout the whole fall and winter and nobody was willing to actually go through and purchase them yet. So they were listed for 159 days before they sold and I'm super happy that they are gone and that I don't have to look at them anymore. I just feel like it's the worst to have those things in your closet that like they're cute, they're getting a lot of attention, but they're just not selling. Oh my gosh, it was so frustrating. So I'm happy they are on their way to their new home now. The next thing to sell was this Victoria's Secret bikini top. This came out of my personal closet, so I was happy to kind of sell it for a lower price. I had this for 257 days. And again, I felt like it was pretty popular. It always got a lot of likes and a lot of interest, but finally somebody made me an offer that I was happy to accept and I am super glad that it it's sold now. The next thing to sell was this Nordstrom sweater. I unfortunately found a flaw on this sweater after I listed it. It was so well hidden that I went through the whole process of like sourcing it, inspecting it, washing it, steaming it, photographing it, and then finally like someone asked me a question about it one time on the listing, and when I pulled it out to look at it, there it was. It was listed for 35 days before it sold, and I used my closet clear out strategy. Someone was willing to take me up on that offer, and it sold for a pretty low price because of that dang flaw. Next up was this Zara embroidered sweater. It was listed for 128 days and it sold because somebody sent me an offer. The next thing to sell are these American Eagle jeans. These sold using my closet clear out strategy as well, and I only had them listed for 14 days. That's pretty typical for me in denim right now. Jeans seem to be selling so fast. And the last thing to sell is this Anthropologie cardigan. It had a lot of activity. Every time I relisted it, it was super, super popular. Someone made me an excellent offer and it was listed for 87 days before it sold. And that's all for this sharing experiment video. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate you, and I will see you in my next one real soon.